DaVinci Junior or Fabrikator Mini? Which one's a better starter printer? Let's print a flexible fish from Thingiverse and find out. It's Filament Friday. Now, one of my viewers, Science Shed, he asked me to print the flexible fish that was featured on Thingiverse and print it on my DaVinci Junior. And here's one that's printed and very flexible. What makes this print unique is that it's a single print. So it's got joints built into it that you print single time, you don't snap it together, and then once you take it off the bed, it should be flexible. That's the test. So my thought was I could try it on a DaVinci Junior, but I also want to try it on the Fabrikator Mini, because these are two printers that are actually very popular entry-level printers. Now, I know a lot of people have taken my recommendation and bought a Fabrikator Mini as a second printer because it's very portable, very easy to use, and I've had really good success with it. But I wanted to see how good it was on a print compared to the DaVinci Junior, because I've actually gotten some decent prints out of DaVinci Junior. So that became the test. Which one really is a better entry-level printer and why? But before we go there, let's check out this design in Tinkercad and go into the inner workings of this print so we understand what we're trying to do.
The fish I refer to on Thingiverse is by user Muzz64.
Now here's the fish brought into Tinkercad, and I turn it into a hole so we can see inside of it. And if we zoom in, we can see there's a post going right through the rib. That's the post that connects it, it's going to pivot on, and then the coupling goes around it. And you can see all kinds of gap between the post and the coupling, and then side to side. So there's all kinds of room here. This thing should be really loose and really floppy. So let's start with Simplify 3D. I got the profile for the Fabrikator Mini, put the fish in place, and I had to angle it at 45 degrees to make it fit. And then I went into the layer setting and set it at 0.2, five top layers, five bottom layers, and infill I set to 20% and removed the support. And then the only thing left I wanted to check was temperature, because I used a PLA black plastic and 205 was the setting, which was good. So then it was ready to slice. So I clicked on it, and look at this, is real time. This is how quick it slices. And it's ready to go. It says 45 minutes to print, 3.4 meters of plastic. Now I went to XYZware. This is the software I have to use with the DaVinci Junior. Same thing, 0.2, 20% fill, start the slicing. And I sped this up because look at, we're at a minute 48 and this thing's still spinning and stopped counting. So it actually took over 2 minutes for this thing to finish. And this is one of the frustrating things about this software. It takes forever to slice. And it said it's going to take an hour and 26 minutes, so it's going to print longer and use about the same amount of plastic. So it's time to print them side by side. Both started printing fine. They stuck to the bed. Everything looked good. And, you know, they both got a very similar E3D copy hot end, so I would expect similar results. So let's see what we get. This is the fish that I printed on the DaVinci Junior. This is the fish that I printed on a Fabrikator Mini with Simplify 3D. Now in the listing, they show them shaking the fish and shaking all over the place. Look at the difference. This one's flopping all over, this one's hardly moving. If I bend it like they show, it bends the same as the listing. This one, that's as far as I can go. So clearly, the DaVinci Junior is not allowing these joints to move as freely as it's designed to move. And just to be fair, I know not everyone has Simplify 3D. I sliced it with Cura, which is a free slicer and recommended for the Fabrikator Mini. Same results, real floppy and bends just the same. So it's not just the slicer, it's also, I guess, a little bit of the machine. But clearly, this slicer takes a lot longer and produces worse results. So for a beginner printer, there's advantages to this, that everything is contained, that you get the software to slice it, you get a nice package. I mean, it's really, this is a nice looking package.
You also get an LCD and SD card slot. That's something I had to add to the Fabrikator Mini. Cost me about $25 and some time.
So there's some things that XYZ Printing does really well as far as
making it easier to get started. But it isn't long before you get frustrated with waiting a long time for the slicing, not getting the prints you want to get out of them. And to me, this is the best printer I have seen XYZ produce as far as quality prints. I've seen what the Pro has done, and trust me, it's not even as good as this. So am I saying don't buy this? No, I'm not saying at all. I've recommended this to people, and I think it's a great place to start. But they're not keeping up, is my point. Because this little printer is less money and prints a lot better. And yeah, it's smaller, so you can't print as big as stuff. But if you're starting out with 3D printing, this thing is giving you what you expect. You've already learned how a 3D print should look. Where here, you're getting 3D prints, but you're really not getting everything you expect. And that's my complaint about what XYZ Printing is doing. They've locked you down. You can't use a third-party slicer. You can't even use different filaments. You only got to use what they offer. And this particular printer, in solid colors, I can get black and I can get white. Other than that, they've got clear, and every other color is a variation off that. Yellow clear, red clear. I just can't get a basic red. I'd love to just have a basic red for this. I can't get it. I'd love to have wood filament, which I proved in a previous video it can handle it if they let us have it. Nope. All of these, including the ones that are available for this, I can print on the Fabrikator Mini. So I'm not limited by filaments. Here I am. I'm not limited by slicers. Here I am. I can't even import just a G-code, slice it, and bring it in. So there's definitely advantages to this thing being easy to use and just a nice looking box. It really is a nice looking printer. But it's got serious limitations, and XYZ Printing, who wants to lock everything down, doesn't seem to want to keep up with what else is out there. So there you go. I don't know what you guys think, but let me know in the comments if you agree, disagree. And I know there's a ton of better printers out there and bigger printers with a lot more choices. I just wanted the two popular low-cost printers. And I know there's more coming, like Mattel's got one coming out, but that's going to be like $299. XYZ Printing's coming out with a cost-down version of this one where it's not going to be in an enclosed box for like $269. And I know of a couple smaller printers that may be coming that I can't say a whole lot about, but it's the sub-$300 3D printer market, I think, is going to expand. So it's going to get even more competitive. So that's it. Sometimes I do print what you suggest, once in a while. I hope you guys enjoyed this, and if you're new to 3D printing, I hope I helped answer a few questions for you, especially if you want to get started for under $300 or around that price range. And if you like the channel and you like what you see, please subscribe. And if you want to help financially, $1 a month on my Patreon account. I try to post extra stuff up there, blog posts, behind the scenes. So for $1 a month, if you can afford it, it helps me a lot, and you get extra stuff, because to me, my Patreon supporters are my super fans. And speaking of them, Roy Olmsted, thank you very much. He sent me some protopasta, some filament to print with, which I'll be using in future videos. Marcelo, who I fixed his printer a few videos ago, he sent me some Florida filament. Thank you for that, I really appreciate it. Joel Telling, when he sent the Wombat, he sent me some ABS rolls, and I've printed some stuff with that. So thank you for the extra stuff. Joel's a supporter on Patreon as well. So all those guys that support me on Patreon and still send me stuff like that, they're super fans. They're just super people, super fans, and I appreciate it. So that's it this week for Filament Friday. I'll see you next time.